into your yin and restorative practice. I'm going to get right into the practice tonight. So if you have any injuries or concerns that may come up for you, listen to your body and to your mind. Listen to your instincts if they are guiding you to go to a place of further depth or intensity. And equally back off if you notice your body is needing you to do less and that is completely okay. Beautiful. We'll start seated to bring a little bit of groundedness and meditation into ourself. I like to cross my feet underneath my knees. You can take whatever seated position works best for you. And you can have the eyes as open or as closed as you are comfortable doing. Begin to allow a sense of softening of easefulness. Sensations in the body soften and release. And for the breath to arrive and go as it needs to. Mind is processing, let it process whatever it might be. Your hands meet at heart center. Place your hands to your thighs as the eyes begin to open up. And bring the soles of your feet together. And I'm sitting on a couple of foam blocks, so I'm going to come off my blocks and instead place those foam blocks beneath the knees so the knees have something to settle into. And instead, sit up on a chip foam block. You can use a pillow as well if you don't have a chip foam block. That can be a good substitution. Let the knees be as wide as they are comfortable. and the feet can be in towards your groin or further out in front of you. One will give you a bit more hamstring, one will give you a bit more groin and adductor release. Take your hands to your feet as you inhale and lift your chest. Exhale, slowly begin to round your spine. Tipping the pelvis forward. Take another inhale. Exhale, rounding in a little bit more. Once more, inhale. And exhale, settling down, letting the head lower, the neck relax, and holding in. Thank you. rest here. Been here for a very long time, so please take time to breathe and to release. Letting the spine neutralize in stillness once you come back to the top. Open, take your hands on the outside of your knees and extend your legs out long. And take your legs out a bit wider and just let your legs and your ankles, feet, flip and flop from side to side. Here, take your left foot to the inside of your right thigh, taking your left knee on top of your block, and then tend to your hands or fingers on either side of your right leg, sitting up for a half butterfly. Inhale, lift your chest up towards the set, towards the ceiling. Exhale, gauge to see how far you can fold and round your spine without over pulling, over extending through that right leg. You would like to use that second block to support the forehead, you can apply that whenever you like. Getting into the back of the right leg, into the hamstrings. drag the right heel back towards you as you bend the right knee. Walk the spine up and inhale. Then close the back of the leg and then hug it in as you breathe into your right thigh. Extend that right leg for a moment. And switching, taking the right foot inside of the left thigh. Having a block handy as well for the forehead. And make sure you're on that chip foam block to keep the hips supported. Turn your chest in the line with the left leg and inhale, lift your chest up. Exhale, tip your pelvis forward. Bow your chest down towards your left thigh.
halfway through the left side. Last couple breaths. Carefully roll yourself up. Carefully draw that left leg in, bending the left knee, softly hugging in to your chest. And then hugging the right knee in with it. Yourself up, and from there find your way to your hands and your knees. Once you find your way to your hands and your knees, go ahead and lean back onto your shins, tops of the feet to the ground. As you bring the tops of the feet to the ground, you can take your fingertips behind you, or your palms down as you start to keep your shins down. And just see if you can lean your chest back a little bit without harming your knees at all. Just getting a slight sensation into your quadriceps here. You can modified version of saddle, staying really high up. Lengthen your tailbone down and forward. Let your sit bones get a bit heavier and breathe into the tops of your quadriceps. Walk your hands back towards you. Come into a folded child's pose. So the knees are touching, legs are touching. Take your palms face up by your sides and let your forehead burrow down towards the ground. Just let yourself breathe into your back. Take your hands out in front of you, roll up off of your thighs, and then shift your weight to your sitting bones out in front. And then tap out your legs. And then we'll set up for very gentle and deep restorative back bend. So we're gonna require 4 foam blocks and 2 chip foam blocks and 2 bolsters. So at either end of your mat, take 1 block flat and the other block on its second height and place a chip foam block over top of the bottom flat block and a bolster over top of that. And then we'll create that at the same, at the back of the mat. Then your sit bones, your seat, can go in between those two structures as you place your legs over top of the bolsters and your spine down the other bolster, coming into a dual reclined posture. If you have a third bolster, you can add it for just a bit of extra weight if you like, whether if it's horizontal or if it's vertical. Is up to you. And then if you have an eye cover of any kind, you're most welcome to apply that over top the forehead without harming the eyelids or the eyeballs with too much pressure. And let your arms come down by your sides and your palms face up. Observing the sensations in your body. third bolster off the side. Roll yourself up to your seat. Well set up for Stonehenge Shavasana. So take your two foam blocks that are at the front of your mat on their highest setting, taking them the same width as the frame of the chip foam block. Create a solid kind of structure. And then you can place your three bolsters mindfully over top as it'll take a little bit of precision so they don't tip over on you. You're also welcome to take your third block. If you have your three blocks, you can actually take three blocks together so they frame that chip foam block even more stable. And then take your second bolster over top and your third bolster over top, and it's going to be very topply and high, like a wall. So you need to bring yourself super close to the blocks in the bolster structure to extend one leg up, keeping the hand on top so it doesn't tip over. Same goes to the other leg, and then still be pretty aware of the fact that it might tip over here. And then lay yourself down onto your back. And then you can use your arms and scoot your shoulders a bit more down your back, and the structure may fall apart. And that's okay. So if it does, first time that's happened, go ahead and just take one bolster on its edge, and take that bolster on its edge and place it underneath your knees. And then you can take Shavasana a little bit more simplistic. And then you can find your eye cover, letting any stimulation go from the light. Your shoulders come down your back. Let your body absorb into the floor. Let the ground receive you.
to lengthen your breath. Making some sensations and movements with your hands and feet. Rolling the body a little bit from side to side. Stretching the arms up overhead, pointing the toes. Bending your knees, placing your feet to the floor, plugging your knees into your chest. And then when your feet touch the ground, you can remove your eye cover, make your way over to your left side. Pressing up to your seat. Bring your hands to heart center. Practicing. Namaste.